Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the Morning Tales for May 10, 2019. And it's 8 a.m. in the morning and I've come up with some of the very important current affairs along with some static questions which are very essential for the examination. Also, you know that the NABARD notification has already come up. So these current affairs are going to help you in the NABARD exam as well. Let's begin with the first question, and this question is for you. So Ganga Ma Jatra festival is the folk festival of which state? This is a very direct question, and a question is usually asked about the folk festival in the examination. So Ganga Ma Jatra festival is the folk festival of which state? You need to mention your answer in the comment section below. So moving on to the first current affair, that is, who among the following is the India's first female full cave diver? Now people have not even heard properly about the scuba diving, but hardly we can expect about the cave diving. But this is for the first time an Indian woman has done the cave diving, and she has become the first female certified cave diver, and the name of the person is Neela Bhaskar. So Neela Bhaskar has gone to Mexico, and that to the cave which she has dived is Angelita. This is the name of the cave. This is in Mexico. So a static question which might come in the examination rather than Neela Bhaskar could be related to this cave, that where is this cave located. So it's located in Mexico. She has actually explored another 30 caves as well, but this is for the first time she has explored the full cave, and she has become the first female cave diver, that is the full cave diver. Very important question and quite encouraging for the women. Next question being the next current affair, what is the theme for the Global Road Safety Week 2019 that is observed between May 6 to May 12, 2019? Now, first of all, this Global Road Safety Week is observed by the United Nations, and they have this theme this time, that is Leadership for Road Safety. So they have for this matter, they believe that the lives could be saved only when people are aware about their precious lives. Therefore, they have started this campaign, that is Save Lives, hashtag Speak Up. Along with this, there was this report, Global Road Safety, that was released by the WHO, the World Health Organization, and it was found out in the report that the road accidents are the major concern for the death among the people, and mainly between 5 to 29 years of age. So this is the age group which are more prone to the road accidents, and the report indicates that 1.35 million people die each year due to the road accidents worldwide. This is the huge number, that is 1.35 million people are dying due to road accidents. If we bifurcate the data among the motorcyclists and the cyclists, so for that matter, the motorcyclists account for approximately 28% of this total number, and the people who are walking by foot or pedestrians and cyclists, they account for 26% of the total road accident deaths. If we need to talk in terms of the countries, then the highest amount of deaths which take place in the country is Africa. They have the highest death rate, while Europe has the lowest death rate. So it has the lowest death rate and it has the highest death rate. So we have talked about Africa and Europe. Now coming to India, what is the status of people dying in India due to road accident? So in India, road rash actually crashes about 150,000 people each year. 1.5 lakh of people die of road accidents each year. This is again a huge number. So to save lives on the roads, these initiatives are being taken by the international organization so that people can get aware about these deaths. Another question for today is, which of the following has tied up with Canada Pension Plan Investment Board to launch India's first renewable energy focused InvIT? So two things in this question. Rather than asking about the company, they could have asked about the Canada Pension Plan Investment Board. Also, the question could have revolved around asking about both the companies, the Canada Pension Plan Investment Board and the company with which they have done this tie-up. So Piramal Enterprises Limited is the organization with which the Canada Pension Plan Investment Board has tied up to launch the India's first renewable energy focused InvIT. Now this InvIT means the Infrastructure Investment Trust. So Infrastructure Investment Trust, this is what InvIT stands for, and this is for the first time that India is going to launch its renewable energy focused InvIT. Now, what is this InvIT? What does the Infrastructure Investment Trust mean? So if we put it simply, then InvIT is a mechanism whereby the developers of the infrastructure assets, they monetize their assets by pooling multiple projects under a single entity. So just like the mutual funds, we could say it is kind of an investment trust for the infrastructure investments. So for the renewable energy purposes, the Canada Pension Plan Investment Board and Piramal Enterprises Limited, they will be launching the first renewable energy focused infrastructure investment trust. Very important question from the exam point of view. Moving on to the next and quite interesting question. So who has become the second most followed politician on social media in the world? So after beating Donald Trump this time, Prime Minister Narendra Modi has become the second most followed politician on the social media in the world. So if we calculate this on the basis of the total followers on Instagram, Facebook and Twitter, then the total audience for Prime Minister Narendra Modi is 110.9 million. Now the question arises, who is the most followed politician on social media? So with the number 182.7 million. So now you need to answer in the comment section below that who is the most followed politician on social media with 182.7 million of followers, including all on Instagram, Facebook or Twitter, all these social media platforms. Another question is, which ministry has decided to do away with the blacklist of Indian origin people? So first of all, this blacklist is prepared by the Indian missions, the Indian embassies in different countries. So this list contains the list of the Indian origin people who have taken the asylum, that is basically the international protection in the other country. Now the Ministry of Home Affairs has decided or has done away with the blacklist of the Indian origin people. And these asylum seekers are predominantly Sikhs. So what used to happen was with these blacklist people were they were denied with the visa services by the Indian embassies in those countries. Now therefore the Ministry of Home Affairs has done away with the blacklist. Nothing much to remember, but quite important and to the point question. Now coming back to the question which I asked you regarding the Ganga Maa Jatra festival, where is this folk festival observed? So for the hint of this, for this question, this state has the bird sanctuary that is known as the Pulikat Lake Sanctuary. So this Pulikat Lake Bird Sanctuary is located in this state where this Ganga Maa Jatra festival is observed. There's one more question for you, and I'll be telling about this question in the next video, the answer for this question. So Chandika Elephant Sanctuary, Nandakanan Zoological Park and Balukhand Konark Wildlife Sanctuary. Where are these three sanctuaries or zoological parks are located? Why this question is in news? Because there the state is too much in news because of the devastation which has been faced by the cyclone. I have given you enough hint for this question. So you need to tell me which state has Chandaka Elephant Sanctuary, Nandakanan Zoological Park and Balukhand Konark Wildlife Sanctuary. These sanctuaries and the animals in these sanctuaries are highly affected by the cyclone. So guess the answer in the comment section below, and do not forget to subscribe to our channel if you have learned anything. Also, we are providing the PDFs and the current affairs for these documents on the website www.anujindal.in. Do not forget to visit the website as well. The links are already mentioned in the description. Thank you so much for watching the video.